Let's turn it off and come back to our flow. Sorry, our automate. I keep calling it flow because of, you know, that it was flow before. So yeah, let's go ahead and edit this. And yep, so we have our HTTP. Let's do this. Let's go ahead and let me check this. It's just a basic get, so that's fine. Yep, we have a get. Okay, so this is where we had a problem. I was supposed to have done this. Put a question mark here. Save this again. And let's try this one more time. Keeping it crossed. If the gods of a demo day will be favorable to us. And there you go. We're being able to run very, very easily and simply using Power Automate, calling a ProDev IoT setup from Automate. Now, the next thing we can do is take this to the next level where we actually implement this in an actual Power App, right? So how about, let's do this. Let's go back in here and then I can change this to off. I mean, I cannot put it in the body because I had this design in a way that I could do that. So let's put this here and then I'm going to save this and let's test the flow again. Run the flow and look at that. Our fan just stopped. So if we want to take this to the next level, all right, how do we do this? So I'm going to go ahead and then I've just, you know, made provision for this. So this is going to be called from a power, you know, from a power up. So let's do this. I'm going to call this one. Let's call this power fan on. And then this is going to be a get. And yeah, we can decide to pass the URL in there if we want to, or not just, you know, not pass it. Depending on how you want to do it, the different ways you want to do it. You can either, you know, passing the state coming in from your power apps. So this is what I would do. Let's actually, we don't need the body here. And then I'm just going to change this. Let's do this from power up. So it's quite easy and simple for us, you know, to do. So people to appreciate it. At least we've seen the flow working. So I'm going to leave that running. Let's come into Power Apps and then make sure I'm in the right tenant. I'm just going to create a very basic, I like it, very basic model, you know, canvas app, and I'll just call it Power Fun. We'll use a phone for now. And yep, asking me to authenticate. Hopefully I will just get this done in time. But I mean, as you can see, it's quite very easy to do that. We've moved from an IoT rig, from IoT Hub, exported, you know, the API into functions. We've been able to use it in Power Automate. I'm just trying to bring it here, skip this. I want to bring it into a Power App to see how that is done. You can follow me on any of my, you know, YouTube and social media channels. I have like detailed tutorials on how to do this. I could even export this into a Power Virtual Agent that, you know, you can interact with to turn, you know, my fan on and off anywhere you are in the world, or you think about it, that, you know, the possibilities are very, you know, are endless. So let's see if we can quickly do this. So let's go ahead and let's put a button here. Yeah, very simple, very, very, very simple button. And then let's go back here to the action and we can do a Power Automate. I'm just going to create a very simple, you know, flow to do that. Hopefully I can get this done in time, but if I'm not able to do this in time, don't worry, you've seen us connected to Power Automate, and that's how it's easy for you to bring your Power Platform stuff into a pro dev situation. So yeah, Power Apps button, this is what I want. Let's click this. It's an instant one. Yes, manual with a custom action. Yep, no additional information here. So the next step here, we're going to do the HTTP. There we go. We're just going to do a get. And then the method, we're going to do a get. And the URL, remember the URL here. But then I'm going to do the state equals, and this I'm going to try to pass this from Python. You know what? Let's just leave it this way so we can just call it directly. We're not passing any variable because of time. Else I would have just created parameters for you to pass from Power Apps into this. So let's just keep it this way. State on and just save this. So let's call this power up. And then save this again. Yep. Awesome. So now, if we came back to, we should see it's changed, but again. So there we go. So on select, I can say, no, let's bring this in first. Yep. And yeah, we're not passing anything. Right, so let's quickly test this quickly test before it's time. I know I have just a few minutes left. Let's run this, and I can see the matching ants.